Hi, I'm Chris from Focusrite Innovation. I'm here at Nevada Music with two brand new Focusrite Scarlett audio interfaces. The top one that we have here is the brand new Scarlett 6i6, and underneath we also have the brand new 18i8. So on the 6i6, basically we have two microphone preamps on the front panel. These are combination connections, so we can actually plug a jack socket in the front there, and we can choose to have that set to either receive a line level, or if we want to plug a guitar directly in, we can also turn that into an instrument level as well. So we have two inputs on the front panel, gain controls here, and behind the gain control we have a halo indicator, and this basically just tells us whether our signal is being clipped or if it's a decent signal being recorded. We also have phantom power, so we can turn on phantom power on the front here. We also are able to use a pad switch, and that is controlled via our mix control software, which I'll show you in a second. Nice big volume control here for your output being sent to your monitor speakers. And also we have two headphone sockets on the front with independent volume control. This is fantastic for letting other musicians listen to mixes while you're working. And the fact that we've got two headphones on there means that you can work it quite easily with your writing partner or production partner. So on the front panel here, two mic pre's. If I switch around on the back, you see we've got an additional set of line inputs as well. And we also have four balanced jack outputs. These can be connected to your speakers, we can also connect to whatever it is that we need to. So if we have two sets of speakers, we could use these perhaps to set up the second pair.
Or, like we did earlier, mm-hmm. on the extra audio out, didn't we?
Oh yeah, of course, yeah, absolutely. So if you want to then maybe take your DAW software and route a signal out via a different output channel, so maybe you want to use a mixing desk to send your mixes out and actually mix directly on the mixing desk, you can actually send out individual outputs from your DAW software into whatever it is you want to send it to. Next to the outputs, we also have MIDI input and output as well to connect any MIDI devices that you may have. We have our USB socket. The Scarlett range of audio interfaces connect via USB. Also power supply, it comes with its own power supply. And here we have a pair of PDIF inputs and outputs. I say pair, basically these are stereo. So this gives us our total track count, if you like, to six. We have two on the front panel, two on the back panel, and then also a stereo digital input as well, giving us six inputs and six outputs directly via the USB cable. So that's the brand new Focusrite 6i6. This is a perfect interface for people wanting to record via microphone or any other sort of sources as well, for example, line sources from synthesizers as well. And we'll give you four distinct analog inputs and then a stereo digital as well. Then moving on to the new 18i8 interface, and we can straight away see a difference here in that we've now got four microphone preamps. These are high quality mic preamps, in fact they're award winning mic pre's, and again we have the same sort of control as we have on the 6i6. We have microphone sockets with combination connections for jack input in the middle. We also have our gain controls, again with halo indicators behind them to tell us about our levels. We have a dedicated monitor output, monitor volume control here, and a mute switch as well, so we can actually kill that volume control as and when it's necessary. So if you're halfway through a mix and the phone goes, it's easy enough, just press the mute switch and the sound's gone. We also have two headphone outputs on the 18i8, and these are actually independent. So what this means is it allows us to set up separate submixes and route them independently out of the headphone sockets on the front panel here. This is ideal for recording if you're working with performers. For example, a singer may not want too much bass and too much drums in their headphone mix while they're singing. Perhaps they just want a bit more guitar or keyboard. But then when you come to actually recording the bass player actually wants a lot of drums in his head, in his headphone mix, perhaps not as much vocalist. What we can do is using the very powerful mix control software, which works with both the 18i8 and the 6i6, and we can actually set up our own little submixes and route them to our independent headphone outputs on the front of the 18i8 audio interface. If I spin this one round, we'll see on the back I have a further four line inputs. This gives us a total analog input count of 8 channels directly through the Scarlett box. But we can also increase that number of channels by using the optical input here. This would allow us to plug in something, for example, like a Focusrite OctoPre, which is a set of 8 microphone preamps with a digital to analog, an analog to digital converter on them, and sends that out via an ADAT optical input, and we can connect it in here and give us a total of 16 analog inputs directly through this particular interface. USB connection, MIDI in and out as well, power supply connection, and then again we have the stereo SPDIF. So the 18i8 is a really powerful box because we can record many sources at one time, just straight out of the box. This is perfect for recording maybe close miking for drums or recording a whole band. And if you find that you do need to increase your input count as well, using the optical input on the back there, we can also do that. So on the mix control as well, just have a quick look at this software. This is the mix control, and this is actually plugged into the 6i6 at the moment. And here we can set up little submixes that I was talking about earlier, and actually do our routing to our different outputs. So here we have outputs 1 and 2, and here we have our headphone outputs on the front panel of the 6i6. So if I have a specific mix, perhaps this particular mix is set up using my inputs and outputs and DAW sources as well. I can choose my sources here. I can set up this little submix and actually send that to the main monitors by choosing in here mix 1. And then for my headphones here, I might want to set up a separate mix and again choose different inputs and outputs and different levels here to be able to create a submix. And then I could send mix 3 out of my headphone sockets on the front. So this is how we would set up 2 separate mixes, send one out to our main speakers and another out to the 2 headphone sockets on the front panel. We also have our pad switches in the software as here, and this will allow us to attenuate any signal that's coming in. If it's a bit too much of a heavy signal or too hot a signal, we can use the pad switch just to bring that down a touch and keep everything in nice and controlled. So those are the 2 interfaces, and with both of the interfaces as well, in the box you will also get a software pack. This includes Ableton Live Lite, over 1 gigabyte's worth of samples produced by our friends Loopmasters, and also a copy of the legendary Base Station software plugin synth. So everything in the box is there for you to be able to get going and record your band or any of your own projects, and it's a great way to be able to start recording music at high quality directly into your computer. Thank you.